Carmina Burana is a work that I created in 2006. I had always known this music. This music seemed to be ubiquitous. It's the most, probably the most recognizable piece of music. People use it for films and besides its original use. And I'd always wanted to work with Craig Hella Johnson at Conspirare. And it seemed like the opportune time. And I had only seen one other work choreographed to this piece of music by the wonderfully creative and renowned choreographer John Butler. But I'd never danced it. So I felt like, because I didn't have that kind of experience with the work already, that it would be the perfect vehicle for me to make a dance to. The history of Carmina Burana is really very interesting. The music that Carl Orff wrote comes from these sort of profane writings. There were 250 manuscripts discovered of writings from priests and student priests from a monastery. Sort of poking fun at the church of that time. And Carl Orff took 24 of these manuscripts and composed his music. Interestingly, it uses, the manuscripts include very ancient languages that aren't spoken anymore. The ancient medieval versions of Latin, German, French, all combined together, making it very interesting. So it's very a very old, it started as a very old manuscript, but bringing it into the contemporary context, when I'm making movement, I really use the style that we work on here, which is ballet-based, but brought into a contemporary fashion. So we build our own vocabulary. I think one of the most compelling parts about this production of Carmina Burana is that when the curtain goes up, nothing is hidden from the audience. The orchestra is in the pit. It's a huge orchestra of about 60 players. The dancers obviously are on the stage. The complete company is on the stage, 20 dancers. And behind the dancers is the full choir of over 150 singers, including three soloists. So the grandeur of the production is evidence in that one image.